Well, the best laid plans of mice and men, right? So my trip back from Birmingham got off to a rather inauspicious start when the train I wanted blew right past me. Not sure why. I think the crew change point has changed from what I understood. Anyway, a little business first, and that is that don't forget, there's a radio giveaway. And for the Baofeng UV-5R that I've got, there's a link in the description that you have to click on in order to enter. You can't just copy and paste that link. It has to come from the YouTube channel, and that's to prevent scammers and bots and everything else from signing up. So anyway, check the link, and also the contact information link is in there. And then I do want to thank all of my channel members for your support. It's fantastic. And if you aren't a member, you might consider becoming one. And then if you haven't subscribed, make sure and subscribe and hit that bell so you get notified when there's a winner in one of my drawing contests. And then in a week or so, I will announce the winner of that radio. So anyway, you know, first time on a new route can be a, shall we say, challenge.
Well, this is pretty much par for the course. Standing in a railroad yard.
Anyway, I better get off the tracks.
It's not a good practice to stand in the tracks. Cool and windy night. Birmingham, Alabama. Probably be daybreak before I have a train out here. Hoping that's not my train over on that other track. I'd have to cross over to the stopped tanker train.
Let's hope there aren't a bunch of stacks on it.
It's just power. Excellent. But now we got something else coming this other way.
Thank you.
something about my train on the scanner. I'm not sure what they were saying. But there's a bunch of trains stacked up here. And I think they were talking that it's going to come in on track 5, maybe, which is several tracks and several trains I would have to cross. So I'm hoping that's not the case, but we'll see. As long as these things are stacked up here, I've got a bit of a problem. Supposed to get on, didn't stop. I think they fueled up and did the crew change while they were getting fuel, while they refueled. And so it just blew on through. And then I was sound asleep. The sun was coming up good and high and starting to get kind of warm. And all of a sudden this double stack pulls in and stops. And I don't know if it's just going to Nashville or what. I don't know what train. So we're on up for a little adventure, I guess. Past a camera, and now we're stopping. Oh, fun times trying to get out of Birmingham. Well, I think it's going to be a beautiful day. I thought I was going to be stuck overnight again. That might not have been a bad deal, actually. It's my train. Pulled up maybe maybe a quarter of a mile after I got on it and then stopped. Then I heard the engines disconnect. And now we're aired back up. So, I'm not sure.
Bam, just like that, we're going again.
Nashville. I could bail there, spend the night, and go on from there. But I don't really know where the train stops there. I guess this one will stop at the same place. But this also works Louisville, Kentucky, and then Cincinnati, Ohio. So I could get off at either of those places and avoid going to North Baltimore. But anyway, we'll see. A little excitement, a little change.
there where kudzu takes over a lot of these trees.
Train apparently. We aren't exactly breaking records today. But at least it's not raining. I'm not really thrilled with this ride. I can't sit and video very easily on it. Beggars can't be choosers. But if I knew how long we'd be sitting here, I'd go look down that, back down the train a little ways. At least to the back end of this car. And the next one. I like it when we stop somewhere where it's secluded like this. I can stand up. Stretch a little bit. It's warming up pretty nicely today. Definitely cool this morning.
Sounds like our DPU is cranked up for some reason.
Now it's going back to normal.
across the Tennessee River drawbridge.
We stopped on a siding just long enough to make myself a cup of coffee. Yay! Oh, hard to drink laying down. Oh, man, beautiful day. I still have my sweatshirt on. I might have to take it off here in a minute. We'll see. When we're moving, it's still got just a little chill in the air, so I'm pretty comfortable. But I think we've been making good time. The speed limits on these tracks through northern Alabama, southern Tennessee aren't that high. I think the most I've seen is 50. And that's probably the fastest we've gone at any one time along here. So some of the time it's down around 35. But anyway, here we go. Back north.
we went through a tunnel, woke me up.
Thank you.
hoping I don't get dropped off here.
Gotten myself in a hell of a bind. I am trapped
in the middle of the yard here in Louisville. So my train broke up, and it seems like it's still a train though. The DPU's on the back of it, just behind me a couple cars, and then I think the power's still hooked up at the front of it, but it just went dead and hasn't moved. I haven't heard anything on the scanner. I haven't had it on for a while, but I don't have a clue how I'm going to get out of here in the daytime. And I'm not sure what to do. You know, sometimes you sit around just thinking about it long enough, a decision gets made for you.
The longer I sat exposed on that intermodal car, the more uncomfortable I got. And I also got thinking that it's quite possible those cars were dropped off here because this is their destination. Anyway, I've switched rides. I'm in a high wall grainer. And it provides some pretty good cover from the sun, as well as anybody going past. I can stretch out here and be below eye level pretty much. You know, there's always a chance you get seen either way, but I think my chances of getting out of here on a ride today are better on this string than on my original intermodal string. But I'll monitor the scanner, and if I hear something contrary, I will adjust my plans accordingly. So there's a one way out. I could go over that way, but I see a fence. But I don't have too many tracks to cross right here, and then another batch over where that maintenance equipment is. I'm giving up. I've wasted a beautiful day, and I think I can get out of here over here. And of course now there's an engine coming. Timing couldn't have been worse.
just gonna go for it because there's gonna be another train coming any moment. Still not off the property, but closer, a little closer. I'm gonna ditch these coveralls, it's way too warm for them, for an old man out of shape. Whew. Yeah, I see a pickup down there. You will hope for the best, but I'm not optimistic. Because it looks like he's coming this way. Maybe I'll get lucky and he'll give me a ride out of here. Yeah, looks like he stopped out there. Saw more than one truck now heading down by those cars coming this way. Makes me wonder if I'm going to have some visitors.
Car is at this point. Where's car 17? You know?
I think I'm just gonna rest here a few more minutes. I've got a good 3/4 mile walk. I'm not even sure that's, oh man, here they come. Looks like I got a whole entourage. Rolling this way. I'm gonna kill this scanner.
Yes, I'll be dispatcher.
See all these vehicles rolling this way? Wow. Well, I'm gonna kill this because I'm pretty sure they're coming for me. Well, do you get lucky once in a while? There's still one more behind them, a pickup truck coming. I don't know. Be nice just to have a lift out of this place. It hasn't been my most pleasant experience by any stretch of the imagination. Wow, not sure what's going on there. That's probably the only way out of here. It's about 5 o'clock. Probably all off work. Whew. Oh well. You can't fence forever, so I'll just walk to the end of it. I'm pretty sure it's a good 3/4 mile. And maybe I'll get lucky with the proverbial hole in the fence when you need it most. Well, change of plans. I'm going to follow the directions laid out for me by the caravan earlier that I thought was coming for me. And we'll go this way. Thank you. See if I can get enough footing to make it across that thing. Man, do my legs feel this. Just a little bit I've walked. A guy my age gets out of shape pretty fast. Kill a video here. I don't want someone seeing the camera on my hat while I'm walking through a place I know I'll be seen. Well, that was quite the chore. So I walked a mile without stopping very briskly and managed to evacuate the property in the most direct way possible. You know, I followed the path that the white vans I thought were coming for me went, and just had to, you know, buck it up and act like I was supposed to be there and just get the hell out of there as fast as I could. So I broke a pretty good sweat. My muscles are burning a little bit. Walking briskly for a mile for me with the pack on is, that's a challenge. You know, especially early in the year. Maybe later in the year wouldn't be quite so bad. You know, I have one time climbing a hill, I hadn't taken my coveralls off and I got overheated. And wow, that took me a while to recover from that, actually, a couple of hours. So I try to be a little more careful in that regard. But, you know, when you get old, stuff doesn't regulate as well. But anyway, I'm waiting on Uber. I am going to go to Cincinnati come hell or high water, so I think I'll buy a bus ticket and get my ass up there. I don't want to fight this. You know, it's kind of a pain when you're alone, you don't know what you're doing. And of course, I almost never know what I'm doing on a first hop to a new place. Once you've done it a couple times, then it becomes like a breeze and much more relaxing. But the first time you do these things, I don't know if scary is the right word. Maybe it's scary. Anyway, we'll see how it goes from here.